So let's continue talking about loops. In this tutorial, we're just going to show some more advanced examples. And then in the next one, we'll apply what we learned. So let's say we have this string given here. It says string traversal. We are going to iterate through this using a loop. So here we have, I typed this ahead of time just to save some time. So here we have a normal for loop with the range function as we saw before. And this time, our range is actually going to be the length of the string. What we use is the length function, which is just len, and inside the argument here is the actual string itself, which we called string. And then we're going to print string with square brackets and I, so kind of like, it looks kind of like an array, since a string is an array of characters. So let's build that, and as you can see, it looped and printed out the actual string. So keeping this kind of method in mind, we also have another way of doing this using characters for loop iterations instead of using the actual range function. So let's do that. Let's erase this whole thing, and we're gonna make a new for loop. For char in string. So we're saying now loop through the characters in the string, and then we're going to print char. And let's build that. And as you can see, you got the same result. This is a simpler way of writing what we just had before. Instead of writing, let me just undo all this, instead of writing this. So you have this cleaned up, neat, explanatory for loop instead of what we had before, which is kind of complicated, but it's all up to you to choose what you're going to use. You can also do, what another thing we have in for loops is you can have nested for loops. So let's write an example out. So let's say we have for I in range 3. As you can see, this writing of loops is simpler than in other programming languages, because Python works with indentation and colons like in the statements. So let's do, whoops, I forgot the n. All right, so for j range 2, whoops, for range 2, and then we're gonna print. So in Sublime Text, it automatically indents for you. Be sure to keep your lines of code indented where needed. All right, let's build that. As you can see, this is our result. All right, so next time we're going to actually apply all the stuff, everything that we learned, in a sort of bigger example, so you can see kind of how for loops can be used in real life applications. And we hope to see you next time.